All right, so get the you set us a whole stack on time travel.
Wow.
Clearly, you're as hooked on this stuff as I am.
It seems so.
We've got articles, research papers, even some of your own notes in the mix.
Wow.
Looks like we're diving deep into not just the science,
Right.
but the philosophy and sheer what-ifs of messing with time itself.
It's a topic that never gets old.
No, it doesn't.
What's fascinating is how much our understanding has evolved from ancient myths to modern
Yeah,
physics.
we're going way past H.G. Wells and Doc Brown here.
Oh,
We're
yeah.
talking about time dilation, those mind-bending wormholes,
Oh.
even paradoxes that'll twist your brain into a pretzel.
And what's particularly interesting is how some of these seemingly outlandish ideas are closer to reality than we might think.
Like, we've got a story about a real-life time
Oh,
traveler,
really?
someone whose experiences touch on the edges of what we think is possible.
Okay.
And you know what's even wilder? You're using time travel calculations every single day without even realizing it.
That's right. It's baked into the technology we take for granted.
Okay, before we get ahead of ourselves, let's rewind a bit.
Okay.
First things first, we need to understand time itself.
Right.
And I've got to say, the stuff you've sent over is making me rethink everything I thought I knew.
I think that's the allure of time travel, isn't it?
Yeah.
It forces us to confront our assumptions about reality.
Totally. Like, we tend to think of time as this absolute, a universal clock ticking away at the same rate for everyone.
Yeah.
But apparently, that's not quite the whole picture.
Exactly. What's key here is Einstein's theory of relativity.
Okay.
It completely changed the game. He showed us that time and space are interwoven, creating this dynamic fabric we call space-time.
So time isn't this rigid, fixed thing.
Not at all. It's relative,
Okay.
meaning it can flow at different rates depending on things like speed and gravity.
Oh, wow.
The faster you move or the stronger the gravitational field you're in, the slower time passes for you relative to someone experiencing weaker gravity or moving slower. It's called time dilation.
Hold on, are you saying that time travel to the future is already a thing?
In a sense, yes. Think about astronauts aboard the International Space Station.
Okay.
They're orbiting Earth at incredible speeds. Because of that speed, time's passing a tiny bit slower for them compared to us down here.
So they're actually like real life time travelers,
Precisely.
even if it's just by fractions of a second.
And this effect, while minuscule in these cases, has some very real-world
Well, I
applications.
bet you're going to talk about GPS, right?
You got it.
That's what I always hear about.
GPS relies on super accurate atomic clocks on satellites orbiting Earth.
Yeah.
And those clocks have to be constantly adjusted to account for time dilation due to both their speed and the difference in gravity compared to Earth's
All
surface.
right.
Otherwise, GPS navigation would be off by miles.
Wow, so that little blue dot on my phone is a testament to Einstein's genius.
It is.
It's like a tiny time machine in my pocket.
And speaking of time machines, let's move on to another theoretical possibility, wormholes. Imagine these as tunnels or shortcuts through space-time connecting different points in time.
Okay, so like in those sci-fi movies,
Yeah.
you can step into one end
Yeah.
and pop out who knows when.
Well, it's not quite that simple. While wormholes are predicted by Einstein's theory of general relativity, we've never actually observed one.
Oh.
And there are some pretty major hurdles.
Like, we'd need to bend the fabric of space-time, which I'm guessing is a little beyond our current tech capabilities.
That's one way to put it. Stabilizing a wormhole would likely require something called exotic matter, matter with negative energy density.
Yeah.
We're talking purely hypothetical stuff here.
Right. So even if we could create one, we'd need this theoretical stuff we've never even seen to make it work.
Exactly. And even if we managed to do all that, who knows where or when a wormhole would lead?
Right.
It's stepping into the unknown in both space and time.
Okay. So wormholes are out there, maybe,
Yeah.
as a huge maybe.
Right.
But I have to ask about the paradoxes. This is the stuff that always gets me. We're talking about the classic grandfather paradox, right? Where you go back in time and accidentally prevent your own birth.
It's a classic for a reason. The grandfather paradox highlights the potential for inconsistencies and contradictions if backward time travel were possible.
Yeah.
It throws the whole notion of cause and effect into question.
It's like if I could go back and change something that leads to me not existing,
Right.
how could I have traveled back in time in the first place? I'm
Exact.
guessing there's no easy answer for this one.
Not exactly, but there are some theories that attempt to address these paradoxes. One idea is the Novikov self-consistency principle.
Let's hear it.
It suggests that even if you tried to prevent your grandparents from meeting, something would always happen to ensure they got together.
Yeah.
Maybe you inadvertently introduced them yourself. Your actions, while seemingly disruptive, would actually maintain the consistency of history.
So it's like the universe has a built-in safeguard to prevent paradoxes.
That's one way to think about it.
Okay, so maybe the past is unchangeable, but what about the future?
Mm-hmm.
Could we really journey to times beyond our own?
That's the million-dollar question, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you've sent over some fascinating material that dives into various possibilities.
Okay, so spill the beans. What are some of the leading contenders for future time travel?
Well, one candidate might surprise you, black holes.
Black holes? I thought those were like cosmic vacuum cleaners, sucking up everything in their path.
Aha!
How could those possibly help with time travel?
It all comes down to their extreme gravity. Black holes warp space-time to an incredible degree. Time slows down significantly near them.
So you're saying if you got close enough to a black hole, time would move differently for you than for someone farther away?
Exactly. Think of it this way. You could spend a short amount of time near a black hole while years, decades, or even centuries pass for everyone else. It's like taking a one-way trip to the future.
Okay. I'm starting to see how that could work.
Yeah.
But wouldn't the intense gravity crush you before you could even experience the time dilation?
That's the catch. We're talking about theoretical possibilities here. Approaching a black hole is an incredibly dangerous proposition. We're far from having the technology to do so safely.
Right. So black holes are a bit of a long shot, to say the least. What else is on the table?
Well, you sent over some intriguing information about cosmic strings.
Ah, yes, cosmic strings. Those are those theoretical one-dimensional objects left over from the Big Bang, right? I remember reading something about them having immense density.
That's right. They're like wrinkles in space-time, incredibly thin, but with immense mass. And some scientists believe that manipulating cosmic strings, perhaps by bringing them close together or near a black hole, could create something called closed time-like curves.
Closed time-like curves. Those sound familiar. Aren't those paths through space-time that could loop back on themselves, essentially leading you back to the past?
Exactly. But remember, we haven't even observed cosmic strings directly yet, let alone figured out how to manipulate them for time travel.
Right. So another big if. But even if we could wrangle these cosmic strings, wouldn't we still run into those pesky paradoxes?
Absolutely. And this is where the conversation gets even more interesting. You've included some really thought-provoking material on the philosophical implications of time travel.
Yeah, the stuff about the grandfather paradox really got me thinking. Like, if you could travel back in time, would you truly be free to change the past? Or is the future, including all our actions, already predetermined?
It's a question that has puzzled philosophers for ages. Does free will exist if we can go back and change events that have already happened?
Or maybe our actions in the past were always destined to happen, meaning the future is set in stone.
That's the deterministic view. And it raises some pretty mind-bending questions about the nature of time and our place within it.
So what you're saying is even if we cracked the code of time travel, we might still be stuck in a predetermined loop. Like even our attempts to change things would just be part of the plan all along.
It's a possibility.
Okay, my head is officially spinning. Can we take a breather and dive into those philosophical quandaries a bit more? I feel like we're just scratching the surface here.
Absolutely. Let's delve a bit deeper.
Okay, so we're back, and my brain is still buzzing from all this time travel talk.
I bet.
We've covered the science, the possibilities, and now we're knee-deep in the philosophical side of things.
Yeah, this is where it gets really interesting. Time travel isn't just about the mechanics of bending space-time.
Right.
It's about how it forces us to re-examine our understanding of who we are and the choices we make.
Exactly. Like we were talking about the grandfather paradox.
Right.
And the whole free will versus determinism debate.
Yeah.
If I could go back and change the past, does that mean I had free will to do so? Or was that action always part of a predetermined timeline?
It's a tough one. The grandfather paradox, while a thought experiment, really highlights the potential for contradictions if backward time travel were possible.
Yeah.
It challenges the very notion of cause and effect.
Right. Because if you change the past, wouldn't that ripple through time?
Would.
And potentially change the present, even erasing your own existence.
Exactly. And that leads us to another philosophical head scratcher, the question of personal identity.
Oh, I see where you're going with this.
Yeah.
If I could meet my past self, would that be two separate individuals, or are we fundamentally the same person across different points in time?
That's the crux of it. Imagine shaking hands with your younger self.
Ooh.
Are you interacting with a different person, or is it a handshake across your own timeline? It makes you think about the continuity of consciousness and what truly defines the self.
It's like if I could go back and give my younger self some advice.
Yeah.
Would it even matter? Would they be capable of making different choices, or are we all just following a set path?
And that ties into the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, which you mentioned in your notes.
Well, yeah, the idea that every decision creates a split in the universe leading to countless parallel realities.
Exactly. So if you travel back in time and alter the past, perhaps you're not changing your own history.
Right.
But rather branching off into a new timeline, a parallel universe where that altered past now exists.
So there could be infinite versions of me out there, each living out different choices and consequences.
That's the mind-blowing implication of the many worlds interpretation.
Okay, I need a moment to process all of this.
Yeah.
It's a lot to wrap your head around. But I have to say, this deep dive has really opened my eyes to the complexities of time travel. It's not just about whizzing around in a DeLorean.
No, it's not. It's about grappling with profound questions about the nature of reality, our place in the universe, and the choices we make.
Exactly. And even if practical time travel remains elusive, these thought experiments are incredibly valuable. They push us to think beyond our everyday experience and consider the deeper implications of these concepts.
They force us to ask what if and explore the boundaries of what we know and what might be possible.
So to all you fellow time travel enthusiasts out there, keep those minds curious. Keep exploring. And remember, time waits for no one. We'd love to hear your thoughts on this mind-bending topic. Share your questions, insights, and theories about time travel in the comments below. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button for more fascinating deep dives into the mysteries of the universe. Thanks for joining us on The Deep Dive.